In the film, you receive a lot of sort of stuffed cuddly animals
Yes.
working on a Disney film. Does that happen in real life when you work on a Disney film?
Well, yes, I've got that bear that I turned into in Brave, stuffed into a cupboard actually, because I'm not big on soft toys. But when I got to LA to do this, I walked into my room and there was this gigantic Mickey Mouse on the bed, huge, but so big that it made me laugh. It really made me laugh because, of course, it was a gag. They were doing it on purpose. I mean, in those days when PLT turned up, the room was just stuffed full of, well, sweets and things, because that was the big thing. Of course, Walt smoked and he also ate loads and loads and loads and loads of sweets. There were sweets everywhere and terrible food, really terrible food on the lot. You know, he was caught in a kind of thing of trying to make everyone's child feel better. I think that was his MO. Not her, not her. I don't think she was the same. But different ways, you know, for these two extraordinary, quite genius, very complex people.
Did you manage to lug that huge bear back to London with you?
Yep.
Do you have to pay extra to get
No,
it in there?
I sent it. I sent it to my daughter, actually,
Okay.
and she's got it in her bedroom.
Okay.
And it's very much, you know, a person.
She is a very, Miss Travers is a very prickly pair,
Oh
on
boy.
indeed. Was that difficult to wake up and have to kind of take that on for the whole
No, it
day?
was bliss.
Yeah.
I just let out my inner prickly pear, which is, you know, pretty active, let me tell you. So it was fantastic. I just wished I could be like that all the time. Utterly honest, even if it means being rude. Oh, wouldn't it be bliss? Wouldn't it be fantastic? No, I don't want to come out to dinner with you because you bore me. No, I don't want to come to the party because I can't be bothered. Would it be great if it wasn't rude, if you could just say what you felt? It'd be lovely, but you can't. And there's something that you can, even if you don't like that person, at least trust. Because you know what they're saying is true. Because none of it was malicious.
So I'm sure other people have pointed this out, but after Nanny McPhee, it seems like, you know, destiny that you would end up playing the creator of the most famous nanny
Yes,
ever.
it is odd, isn't it? I mean, it's not in any way. I mean, who knew? It came along, but it is odd, I think.
Did you have a nanny yourself when you were growing up?
We had au pairs. We had a particularly difficult one who once stole all my Meltis Newberry fruits after I'd had my tonsils out, and they were the only sweetie I could eat. I remember she nicked them and she smacked us, and I ran away with my sister when I was six, took her out the house with a plastic bag full of Ryvita sandwiches, Ryvita and Marmite. Yes, it's an intense relationship if it goes wrong, particularly.